No.
This is Catherine Mathis, counseling with Joyce LaBelle for the class Basic Counseling with Dr. Green. Good evening, Joyce.
Good evening.
What brings you in today?
Well, I don't know. I had a pretty good day. I'm glad that I'm at that other school. It's a lot better there than it was at the one where everything's kind of crazy. Sort of felt kind of weird because I heard the lady that is over the school where I am. Mm-hmm. She was gone today, so we had the lady just above her that does all the different campuses, and she was talking about how the other teacher was doing really well at the school where I was.
Mm-hmm.
It was a little tempting to feel kind of jealous or to feel kind of put down by that, but I don't think that it means anything. I think that just I don't know. I mean, for one thing, he's a guy, and mm-hmm. there's some pretty tough kids over there. And if it's working for him, I'm glad for him. I'm trying not to to think that that's saying anything bad about my teaching skills.
So it sounds like you reached a great point in your life now since you've changed to another school.
Oh, yeah. It's definitely a lot better than it was. It was just crazy. It was pandemonium at the other school. And, you know, that the teacher said that he just came in, and the new guy, mm-hmm. and he came in and he said, well, I don't know who was teaching you before, but I'm in charge now. This is how it's going to be. And it's like, okay, you know, if he can pull that off, more power to him. Because the problem I had mostly was not with my group. I mean, they acted like kids, you know. But with the other groups that were around, that mm-hmm. the teachers were letting them run wild. So it was kind of an ongoing issue with that. But if he can do it, good, more power to him. I'm happy where I am now. So.
Well, it sounds like you're more happy. Would you care to share more about that?
Oh, yeah. I mean, I'm coming back not just completely exhausted every day, not just completely feeling kind of beat up every day.
Mm-hmm.
I feel good about today now. I feel good about what I did today at the school. I felt successful. I felt doing it well. So I'm just much happier with it.
Well, that's good. But what are some things that's different, that you feel that's different at this new location?
Well, when I first went there, I thought, wow, this lady that is in charge here,
mm-hmm.
she kind of kept, it felt a little bit like she kept getting on to me and kind of micromanaging everything I did, because she wanted it down to the second. The schedule followed right to the second, and I felt like she was just correcting me. She'd walk up to me and she'd say, how many kids have you got? Before all the kids were even there, and I'd start to count, and she'd be like, no, don't count, you have to know at all times.
Mm-hmm.
But then after I kind of got used to her and the way that she does things, I feel like the structure is good. Mm-hmm. It really works. And she did tell me, it was the first day I was really happy to not be at the other school.
Mm-hmm.
The second day I was kind of like, is she picking on me? You know, mm-hmm. what's going on? Then after that, she told me, she kind of said, you know, a lot of people think I'm strict. It's just that, you know, I really like to keep order. And she said that the lady that's in charge of all of it, that's mm-hmm. over, she said she had her job before she retired, and
mm-hmm.
she knows a lot about the inspectors and stuff. So after she told me that, I kind of felt, I didn't ask her, she just
mm-hmm.
said that, but I felt like it was a little bit of an explanation as to what was going on, you know, with that. So she's very particular about her school,
okay.
which is good.
So when she shared that feeling with you, it made you feel a little bit more confident.
Yeah, I felt better because I didn't think, wow, she just really doesn't think I know what I'm doing. You know,
mm-hmm.
I wondered if she thought because I had to trade schools that maybe I was a bad teacher. You know,
mm-hmm.
I kind of thought, what
mm-hmm.
is she thinking here? But after she shared that, I felt like, you know, she's just kind of getting used to me, and she has her way that she does things, and
mm-hmm.
she wants to be sure that, you know, everything's orderly. And so I felt a lot better about it after that.
Well, it sounds like you feel a lot better now than when you first got there. It seems like you feel a lot better and more happier.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it was crazy before.
Okay.
So.
Yeah, because I remember the first time you shared that with me, it was kind of, you know, you kind of felt very not satisfied where you were at that time. But from where your expression is now,
yeah.
I can tell it's different.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I felt really kind of like a failure before
mm-hmm.
because the kids were just, the every direction, which mm-hmm. I tried, but it felt like, especially because we're all in the same room, mm-hmm. and the other kids in the other classes were running around acting crazy, they would be like, well, they get to do this, and they get to do that, and I'm thinking, you know, their teachers aren't supposed to let them do that,
mm-hmm.
but, you know, like I said, if this new teacher that's there, the one that I traded places with, if he is able to stand up to those teachers and say, hey, you can't do this, then good for him.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't that I couldn't. I felt like it was in place.
Mm-hmm.
I felt like that was the supervisor's job and not my job.
Mm-hmm.
And so there was this really weird, awkward kind of thing
okay.
that was going on where I felt like, you know, I would correct his kids and stuff sometimes,
mm-hmm.
but I kind of felt like I was overstepping my bounds in doing that. But sometimes I felt like I had to do it, and, you know. So it was kind of just a really weird situation.
So what I hear you saying is that you feel like if you didn't do it, you know, that if you didn't redirect him, that he wouldn't redirect him. I mean, that if you didn't redirect him, then they would be more out of control.
Yeah, and I mean, it was kind of, like there was one time where we were all in the same room,
mm-hmm.
and I looked over there at his group of kids, and they were running around, and they had made some kind of jump rope out of something, and they were all, like, one was turning around, and they were all jumping in. But they aren't supposed to be doing that in
mm-hmm.
the cafeteria. You know,
mm-hmm.
they can play jump rope in the gym and stuff, but they're not supposed to be running around there.
Okay.
So.
Okay.
But, so, I said something to the supervisor.
Mm-hmm.
I said, are they supposed to be doing that?
Mm-hmm.
And so she went over there and said something to him. Well, he had like an iPod, and he was listening to it.
Okay.
And so he didn't hear her say anything, and she said something again, and finally he heard her. But I just kind of felt, that was kind of, I think, the turning point for me, because I thought, I'm not supposed to be supervising all of these children. That's not what I'm here to do. And
okay.
I'm having to tell the supervisor to tell him.
Okay.
It was just, anyway.
Okay.
So, glad I'm out there.
Yeah, so, well, we only have a few minutes more to go, Joyce, in our session today.
Mm-hmm.
Is there anything else that you would care to share?